Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to Rocket League News. This is a series where I talk about all the information. You guys are too lazy to look up everything that happened within the last week in Rocket League. If you do enjoy, as always, consider hitting subscribe for more. And without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first story of the day, oh my gosh, this comes from the most recent RLCS broadcast. This was the first match of NA. The legend himself, Fireburner, subbed in for Game 5 and carried C9 to a victory. Now, for those of you who don't know, Fireburner is one of the greatest Rocket League players of all time. He's retired. He's now currently a coach for Cloud9. And he's arguably still better than most pros out there. He is pretty insane. And he's just well-loved by the community. Just a big, big name. Honestly, if you haven't heard of him at this point, it's because you're probably new to the scene. But Game 5, Torment disconnected, and they needed to sub Fireburner in. And oh my gosh, Fireburner carried Cloud9. And let me tell you what was on the line. Cloud9, if they'd lost that game, they're probably looking at a promo relegations tournament spot. Their RLCS life was on the line. And Fireburner carried Squishy and Gimmick to a victory. And he obliterated Sonics. It was just amazing to watch. It was incredible. For anyone who hasn't seen that match, go watch it. But with that said, Cloud9 is now no longer facing relegation. And it's pretty much thanks to Fireburner. This next story is kind of a two-parter. So an update on the RLCS Season 9 World Championship. This comes from Cyanix at RocketLeagueSports.com. And they basically said that RLCS Worlds is canceled for good. I previously talked about this in another video that I posted yesterday. I'll link that in the description for those of you who want more information on this. But basically, Cyanix said that there just will not be any Worlds. Worlds just will not be happening because of the coronavirus. It just is not a possibility at this time, and it's pretty unfortunate. Leading into that, we have a Reddit post talking about how teams are losing motivation with no LAN, but a lot of the professional players are losing motivation in this season of RLCS. Literally the only goal for some of these pro players is just not get relegated. Because for those of you who don't know, it's not about the money. The pro players get paid extremely well by their orgs, and the money that comes from these tournaments, the pro players just do not care about. For them, it's all about the glory. And Yummy Cheeseman, the coach for Reciprocity, talks about this in his Reddit post, that there's a lot less pressure for these pro players at the moment. Teams never played for the money. It was for the chance to win Worlds and getting invited to all the other events. This is especially true when teams already get paid salaries. There's still a lot of personal pressure to perform well and especially not to get relegated. And for all the teams, it's about looking at the second half of the year. Then he said again, all the players get paid quite well by orgs and the minimum prize pool that comes with RLCS. Sure, some extra money is nice, but the glory is better. Basically, a lot of pro players have been coming out and saying that they have already checked out of this season of RLCS. And it's kind of sad because that means a lot of these teams are not going to be playing as hard as they can in RLCS for these last couple weeks. But basically, this is the current state of Rocket League, so it's my job to update you guys on it and everything that's going on. But yeah, the coach for G2 talked about how G2 just wasn't feeling it right now. Squishy Muffins talked about it on his stream. Justin talked about it. Just all the big names in Rocket League. I mean, they just looking forward to the second half of the year. That's really what they're doing. What this really means is that literally anything can happen next week at Worlds. Like, anything. We could see G2, NRG, Sonics, Space Station all lose because, I mean, why not? Literally, the only team that's trying right now is Flight because they're in that auto relegation spot. Now, let's get on to the next story. I talked about in, I believe it was the last edition of Rocket League News, that Space Station Gaming and Hot Wheels collaborated and made a Hot Wheels car. And I was talking about how maybe companies and esports organizations will do another collaboration in the future. Well, it just happened with Cloud9. And Puma. Cloud9 came out with their own merch sponsored by Puma, and I'll put the link in the description, and it looks like some of the best fucking org merch that I've ever seen. Cloud9 has always been my favorite when it comes to merch. Like, I love G2, but Cloud9 is just, they look so clean. They know how to make merch. Yeah, I'll put the link in the description to uspuma.com. And yeah, some of this stuff just looks really cool in case any one of you guys is interested in getting any of that, or at least checking it out. I mean, there's a lot of it. Next up in the news, this one comes from Johnny Boy, and if anyone's watched RLCS, you'll know this, but Johnny Boy tweeted out that he's really excited to announce that he'll be on the casting crew for the remainder of RLCS Season 9. Also, on top of that, Shogun is going to be casting again for the remainder of the season. So Johnny Boy never casted for RLCS League play, basically because he has to fly into America and he had to stay for so long. It would not be just a one weekend thing. He would be there. He would be in America for multiple months at a time. And that's a lot of, that's just a lot of time from away from his home and family, blah, blah, blah. But since RLCS is online, Shogun, Johnny Boy, they can both actually cast, and I think it's awesome. Shogun is, in my opinion, the best Rocket League caster that there is. He just brings so much hype. He makes every single match, no matter what it is, feel like it's the RLCS Grand Finals. I mean, he does such a fantastic job. I really am happy that Shogun is back, even if it's just for 2 weeks. And last but not least, this next one comes from Alpha Console. And I'm sorry to say, but Alpha Console has shut down, and Bakke's Mod is now the only service where you can view MMR in-game. Now, when you boot up Alpha Console after the latest update, this message appears. I'll put it up on screen. They're just saying that it's sad to announce it's come to an end. And basically, the motivation to continue is at an all-time low for the developers. Basically, a lot of people like Alpha Console for their custom in-game titles that you can make. And that is something that Bakke's Mod doesn't have. And Alpha Console has said that they're looking to bring all the features that were on Alpha Console to Bakke's Mod. And since they're doing that, it looks like there is absolutely no chance in the future for Alpha Console to come back. Because now the only thing that separates those two, Bakke's Mod will now have. And then they say thank you for the 3 years of memories. But yeah, it kind of sucks, but that's just the way it goes. Yeah, that is basically everything for the news this week. Thank you guys all for watching. Hit subscribe if you did enjoy and you want to see more. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.